my Brannigan's corner one morning night astray. I met a fellow rebel, and to me he did say, we have orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar, but how are we to get there without a motor car?
Oh, Barney dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what we'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, but the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranlar, and we give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnson's motor car.
When Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his castor hat and on his breast a star. You could hear the din all through Glenfin of Johnson's motor car.
Ah, but when he got to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there. Oh, Johnson knew the game was up, but at him they did stare. He said, I have a permit to travel near or far.
To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car.
What will my loyal brethren think when they hear the news? My car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at the loose. He'll give you a seat for it, all signed by Captain Barr.
Come on, Ireland, get your freedom, by you'll get your motor car. Well, they put that car in motion and filled her to the brim, with guns and bayonets shining, which made old Johnson grim. And Barney heist to the shin pin, pilot for their leg a star. Have a gift, cheers for the IRA and Johnson's motor car.